morning. Welcome to worship this morning. Today is Sunday, December 6th. It is the second Sunday of Advent. I'm Jane McCready. I'm the pastor here at Faith Lutheran Church in New Providence, New Jersey. With me this morning is my colleague, Shay Veloso, our minister of music, along with John Everson, who is our assisting minister this morning. And my thanks to Alex Bonenberger and to Gary McCready, who are recording our service for us today. A reminder that we will be having, we'll be singing some carols after our service this morning. So following the postlude, you can stick around and join us for that as well. This week, we also have our midweek Advent service, and that's on Wednesday at 12 o'clock noon on Facebook Live. And following that service, we will go right into an organ recital and hope that you can join us for that as well. A reminder that we are collecting used books. We are recycling those in a green bin that's right in our parking lot here at church. We also have a table set up in Franklin Nelson Hall. If you just can't part with some of those books and you think that folks might enjoy reading them, you can leave them on the table down the hall, and folks will pick those up, and hopefully they'll have another chance at a new life as well. Thank you for sharing those books with us. This week, we dropped off more than 850 sandwiches at Soup Kitchen in Newark, and along with toiletries and clothing, breakfast bars, what else, snacks, baked goods, all sorts of goodies. And we will be doing that for the next several months every Thursday. Just drop off your donations by 9 o'clock on Thursday, and we will get those over to Soup Kitchen. Our sharing tree gifts were delivered this week. Thanks again to Joanne and Ed Berryman, who guide that ministry for us. We shared gifts with the Ark of Union County, with Cheshire Home in Florham Park, with our partners at St. Stephen's Grace in the Ironbound, and locally here in New Providence as well. This week, we also shared gifts. We shared gifts with Family Promise, our hospitality ministry. We shared gift cards from ShopRite and Uber. This was actually a week that we were going to be hosting Family Promise here at Faith. And to help offset their expenses, we gave them a very generous donation of gift cards. New or changes to the prayer list, we ask that you remember John Bjorge, who is recuperating from a procedure earlier this week, and Peggy Glassman, Carol McPherson's sister-in-law, who is undergoing tests and treatment. And we also ask your prayers for the family of Pete Bickness, who is a friend of Janet and Carl Keebler. Next week, on Tuesday the 15th, we have our menorah lighting here at Faith. If you drove by the church this week, you might have noticed that we have our menorah out on the lawn, along with our sign, and our creche is there as well. We will be joined by Rabbi Friedman and Rabbi Glazer from Summit. And that will also only be online this year. It is our 14th annual menorah lighting, and hope that you will be here. Well, you will be here on in spirit and on Facebook to join us for that. I would invite you now to join me for our confession. Trusting in the word of life given in baptism and hearing God's call, we gather to worship in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with one another a sign of God's peace. Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Stir up our hearts, Lord God, to prepare the way of your only Son. By his coming, strengthen us to serve you with purified lives. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The Old Testament reading for today is taken from the book of Isaiah, 40th chapter, verses 1 through 11. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her. She has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I say, what shall I cry? All people are grass, their constancy is like a flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom, and gently lead the mother sheep. The word of the Lord. The second reading is from 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 8 through 15. But do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and the heavens will pass away with a loud noise, and the elements will be dissolved with fire, and the earth and everything that is done on it will be disclosed. Since all these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you to be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of the God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire. But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth, where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation. Word of the Lord.
gospel is recorded in the first chapter of St. Mark, beginning with the first verse. Glory to you, O Lord. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight.' John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, 'The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit.'" This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Our lessons today are about God's messengers, those people who find us no matter what. It doesn't matter where we are or what we're going through or how we're living. It's in the midst of whatever wilderness we find ourselves in. We're talking about people like Isaiah and John the Baptist. Isaiah, who pointed God's children to a new world where God would restore all things to the way they should be. Isaiah, who pointed God's children to Messiah, who would comfort and care for them in all things and in all days. And we're talking about John, who pointed people to a need to change their lives and to return to God, to return to God, to turn back to God. And if you need to be reminded of that image, just take a look at our pyramid that we have on the altar, with the figure pointing to Bethlehem where hope and life are born, where hope and life lay in a cradle. And it points to Jerusalem where hope and life hung on a cross. It's an interesting perspective, and for most of us, we need those reminders, and we need both of those images. That here we are in what seems like an exile for months now, living in the midst of a worldwide pandemic. And yet we continue to gather in this new way, surrounded by hope and promise. And we continue to gather in this season of Advent, where we're surrounded by expectation and longing as we await the coming of Christ. On days when the world and life can seem so overwhelming, how good it is to be reminded of the comfort of God that speaks tenderly to us and gathers us and takes us where we need to be. And on days when we wander and roam, it's good to have those messengers to hear the words of Isaiah and John that point us back to where we need to be. Those messengers in today's lessons are a reminder of our ministry in this Advent season. You and I are called to be God's messengers. By our words and by our ministry, we need to point people to the Easter message of hope, to Isaiah's promise of that new kingdom where God tenderly cares for all children, and especially the most vulnerable. By our words and by our ministry, we need to point people to John's call for repentance, because our greed and our overindulgence aren't things to be envied and things that we long for, no matter what the message society gives us. Greed isn't a Christian lifestyle, no matter how many times it's repeated. Independence and self-sufficiency may make for great work ethic and political argument, but it hardly fits with the biblical understanding of community. God expects more, and that's why God puts the baptized all over this world to point the way. Our baptismal theology says it quite concisely and clearly. We are called to be in, but not of, the world. This week, like so many before, has shown us the different paths God's messengers lead us. To a soup kitchen in Newark and to an ARC home in Forum Park, to neighbors in New Providence and to an immigrant community in the Ironbound, and off to Elizabeth and to Plainfield, caring for growing numbers of people struggling to eat and find affordable housing. Each day, messengers are assuring every one of God's people of the hope that comes in the form of a child, and never leaving us alone in the wilderness. These messengers remind us of the past, and they lead us to the present and point us to the future. Advent is a time for hearing and sharing the promise of hope. It's a time for hearing and sharing the faithful call to ministry. Amen.
We're going to do a fun one this morning. If you're so inclined and the Spirit moves you at home, sing along. I'll feed you the words. He came down that we might have love, light, peace, and joy. Okay, Jay? Confess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate by the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. With longing and hopeful expectation, let us pray for the church, for the world, and all people in need. Gracious God, as we await for your coming among us, we pray for your church on earth, that it may be a herald of glad tidings, announcing the good news that you are drawing near. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for leaders of this and every nation, for all who strive for peace and an end to conflict and war, that righteousness may find a home in their midst. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for wilderness and deserts, for mountains and plains, fields fallow in winter, and for fruitful vegetation during these summer months in the southern hemisphere. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all among us who are hurting today, those who are weighed down with economic instability, sorrow, anxiety, or sickness, that you speak tenderly to them and comfort them in your compassion. We remember especially Ben and Joe, Rosalie, Mona, Floyd and Judy, Paul and Chris, Bob, Annalise and Sandy, Ursula, Nancy and Bob, Marilyn, Linda, Don, Emily and Marge, Evelyn, Fred, Mike, Milton, June, Carol, Joyce, Kelly, Bob, Tommy, Peter and Ed, Michael, Lance, Jeff, Tony, Jill, Corey and Kristen, and John, all those whom we name before you in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, we pray that you bring peace and consolation to the families and friends of Pete Thickness and John Crane. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for this community, our family of faith, that in these busy and anxious times, in this time of COVID, you will give us the gift of patience and trust in your steadfast love. Help us to look beyond ourselves and do what we can to help our neighbors in need. Lord, in your mercy. Lord, we give you thanks for all the saints who have gone before us and faithfully prepared the way of the Lord. Open our eyes to the new heavens and new earth made known in your coming among us. Lord, in your mercy.
Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all those for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray now as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, for whom we wait, you come to us by grace and give us life. Make us ready to welcome Christ into our hearts and send us forth announcing your coming among us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the Lord who created the earth and the stars bless your Advent waiting. May the long-expected Savior fill you with love. May the Spirit guide your journey and give you strength. In the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, prepare the way of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Thanks for sticking around. We're going to do three carols this morning. So if you have your hymnals at home, I would encourage you to grab those and you can sing along. The first one that we will do is number 248, People Look East. Okay, that's number 248.
Thank you.
something that is probably a bit more familiar to all of us. Number 282, it came upon the midnight clear. And we're going to do all four verses of this one.